Leadership is a fundamental privilege. Leading American sons and daughters in combat is a privilege, the highest privilege that we can bestow in our profession. I think if you treat every day like your job is a privilege, like leading people, like dealing with their problems is a privilege, as opposed to some kind of a burden, you're going to have a great career.
Met on the shores of the Hudson River, where we became mere civilians, all with the different things. Him hopes on a football, and mine on hockey. And so it's been great to know him for coming up on over 39 years. He is a leader that his words meet his match his deeds. He's a cavalryman. You know, he has spirit. He has a great inherent love for warfare, not only its history, but also its the execution of it. You know, he's led his corps into in combat, and as a great cavalryman, there's not a fight that he's not back down in. But he's always thinking of ways to win that fight in innovative ways, and using imagination and spirit to be successful, which means then you win and bring back your soldiers safely.
He is charismatic. You look at him as a leader, you walk into the room, he commands attention, and I think that that's one of the prerequisites for leadership at all ranks. And that, coupled with his extraordinary intelligence and understanding, his ability to communicate, you've got what could be called the exemplary general for the United States Army.
How would you best describe General Cone? I think a man of ethics and values, and somebody who maybe by his position knows he's a role model, but he's a role model because of his actions, not because he's a four-star general, just because of how he interacts with people, how he treats people, how he engages with people, and how he values different vantage points and different views on issues in order to, you know, build his understanding of issues. So I think that it's something all of us as leaders can easily look up to and say, we want to be like that.
He's an innovator. From the time I met him in 98 and throughout the rest of his career, he has been an innovator, using the past to push us forward, making sure we don't repeat the past. But it's that training that comes out in him and all the soldiers that he touches, from the private to the NCOs to the officer corps. He'll leave his legacy as a trainer in the Army. Looking forward.
When I think about what type of leader General Cone is, it strikes me as a person that operates on two planes, regardless of rank, regardless of position. On one plane, there's a personal leader, and whether I've seen him serving as a four-star, and I've seen him serve as young as a major, and on all those instances, the people he interacts with in a direct supervisory capacity, there's a personal aspect that looks directly after taking care of that person's needs and their personal and professional development. Concurrently, organizationally, he is the epitome of mission command. It is, here are your left and right limits, here's what's important to your chain of command, here's what's acceptable, here's what's not acceptable, now with these resources go forward and make us proud. And he genuinely inspires people through his personal leadership to take advantage of what Mission Command provides and his ability to articulate and empower people through Mission Command. It's pretty awe-inspiring.
the single word that describes General Cone, but I got to use it to describe both him and Jill Cone, and that's genuine. They are genuine people from the first day I met him till today, and in the foreseeable future. They are just down-to-earth people. When you're around them, you'll recognize that. Their general love for soldiers, their families, it's all genuine. And both of them have put their heart and soul into the military.
Bob Cone was a great TRADOC commanding general, especially at this time in the Army's life cycle. We say that we're moving from an army of preparation for war as opposed to being an army at war. And that is all about changing the army. And so this big ship of the United States Army has been steered in a new direction thanks to General Bob Cone.
I think he leaves a legacy of, and really a bar that's raised to a level of, this is how you train soldiers, and this is how you do it right. And in order to get soldiers to do what they need to do and to win the wars that our nation needs to win, this is the bar that General Cone has established.
Sir, you've been a great friend, you've been a great boss, and we wish you and Jill all the best.
Sir, I just thank you, and Jill, I thank you for your service to our nation, to our Army. I wish you all the best in the future. I don't know about your Packers, I'm still a Giants fan, but I hope you enjoy your retirement, and thank you for everything you've done for our Army.
Sir, ma'am, Carol and I wish you the very best in the future as you move off to the cheesehead land of Wisconsin. Always know that you are in our thoughts and our prayers. Godspeed.
The most important thing I can say to you, sir, is thank you for the opportunity to serve with you. It's been the high point of my career in the Army.
General Cone, Jill, in your retirement, it goes with my best wishes and our hopes. And Ann and I can't wait to see what an incredible difference you're going to make in the next chapter of your life. We'll be in touch. Thank you for everything.
General Cone and Jill, Holly and I would just love to wish you a happy ending to a phenomenal success story, and that is the service that you provided to our nation and our country. I personally want to thank you for everything that you've done to better our soldiers, and more importantly for me is our non-commissioned officers and the work that we've done here in Training and Doctrine Command. It has been an absolute pleasure to serve by your side and an absolute pleasure to watch you work every day. Good luck and Godspeed.
Thanks for your leadership and what you've done for me personally, and me and Karen personally, but also for the whole command. You will be missed, and we're always looking to the next time we can meet on Fiddler's Green and share in some libations and talk about the great war stories we had as soldiers. So best of luck to you and Jill, and top of the line, 79.